Thank you. Okay, you guys, I got a scale here and we're going to weigh out our big jug here so we know what the weight is. We'll try to just do a tear weight on it, but yeah, it's getting kind of weird here. Well, I suppose helping turning it on would be good. All right, so we're at zero. And just for the camera, let's find out what this thing weighs. 2451, so we'll just call it 2450. Call it good. Okay, so now, what we need to do is we need to put our goodies in the jug. All right, let's. There you go. Now you guys can see. All right, so let's start putting our goodies in the jug. Now, the game is here, we're going to put the fruit, and then we're going to put weigh it again, and whatever the fruit weight is, we're going to put half the amount of sugar in weight. So let's get our fruit in here first. No particular order, I'm just starting with blackberries. They're just at hand here. It's a little bit of water, no big deal. So there's our blackberries. We got our golden plums from our tree, if you watched the other video. Just a couple of those there. We've got our raspberries. Again, it doesn't matter what order you put these in. And I'm gonna put the pineapple last because I don't know how much there is of that. Or maybe second to the last. Okay, our raspberries. Our strawberries. I'm making a big mess. Gotta do an Instagram photo. One for the camera, two for the show. Let's put some more strawberries. Come on, let's go. All right, strawberries. Oh, it looks so good, you guys. Okay, you guys, now I'm only going to put in half of our cherries. We've got a ton of cherries. So let's start with half, just in case, because I've got some other fruits to go in here. And I didn't know this would get quite so full. All right, so there's about half of our cherries. And then what you didn't see is I cut up some peaches offline earlier. They were a mess, so didn't really need to see that. You can see they're a little bit brown, no big deal. All right, let's try about half of our blueberries. Wow, this is getting really full. I'm kind of in shock. All right, about half of our blueberries there. Alright, and then I'm going to put in a couple good handfuls of pineapple. That's the Californian in me. Got to put all the fruits. Alright, so yeah, that's topping us up quite nicely, so we need to pause there. Okay, so I have a lot more fruit than I thought I did, or this jug is not very big. I only think this is maybe a gallon, gallon and a half, but that's fine because it totally looks great. Let me show the camera a little bit here. Whoops. Look at that, you guys. That is very exciting. Exciting and new. All right, so let's give that away and let's find out where we are on that. I don't even know if the scale is going to be able to hold this much. Let's see what happens. Let's see. 58, 55. Okay, guys, some quick math here. So 2855 minus 2450 is 2605. So according to my calculations on this tiny piece of paper with Spider-Man on the back, we need 1305 grams of sugar. So 1300 grams of sugar. So let's weigh that out. All right, we'll get a tare weight here. Tare weight. Okay, so I've decided that I'm gonna do about a quarter of it to brown sugar. We're using white rum, and I love the taste of brown sugar. So let's just start with some brown sugar here. So maybe, 400 grams or so. Let's see, one chunk. Trying to get to 1300. I need a spoon, because it's chunky, or better yet, a knife. Here we go. Chunky. All right. Let's see where we are with about 13, or about 300. 1,300 grams. All right, 300, maybe a little bit more. There we go, about 3.5. All right. Remember, still going to 1300. And now I just have some plain white sugar. I thought about getting organic and turbinado and blah, 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 blah. But, it doesn't really matter in this. So, all right. 1300. That's a lot of sugar. Gonna be a, whew. All right, let's do 900 in here. Nine, close enough. And then get another bowl. And another 400 in here. Oof, too much. Trying to be a little close to the recipe in my head. All right, close enough. All right, 1,300 grams of sugar. Got our jug back here again. All right, so let's put our sugar in. You guys can see that all right, I think. All right, so might have to do this in two shifts. Put the sugar in. It's filtering quite nicely in. That's pretty cool. Instagram shot there. All right, here's what I'm going to do. Since we're just going to fill this up now with rum, I'm just going to put enough rum just to melt the sugar down. Just a little bit of rum. A little bit of rum. Found an extra berry. Alright, let's try to pour some more of this in. I feel like I'm making a mess. Alright. A little more rum. Wash it down. Washing it. Alright, washing it down. I need to make a little pocket. There we go. Create a little erosion. Rum, 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 rum in your tum, tum, tum. Okay, now I'm feeling like we need to get these big brown chunks in here first. I'll just smush it down a little bit. Don't worry, it'll dissolve eventually. What they say, add the big aggregate first, and then you can add the little stuff on top. All right. Brown sugar always gets chunky. Now, it's very American to use brown sugar. I know, but you know what? I love the taste of brown sugar. All right. Now, a little more erosion. the Germans can cringe now. It's all right. All right, look, we're getting all our 1,300 grams in there. Because remember why? Because it's half the weight of the fruit, which was 2,600. All right, I'm gonna rinse out the bowl here. Whew, I tell you what, it smells extra rummy in here. Now, we're gonna need to squish this down a little bit because we're supposed to have at least 2 centimeters, according to everything I read, 2 centimeters of top space for rum. And since we are kind of full here, we're gonna need that to mush down a little bit. All right, just rinsing our spoon. Oh, it's looking good, you guys. Make a space. There you go. All right, let me rinse off our spoon. Make sure we get it all. And now look at that, chugging it. Chugging. Oh, we might use this whole rum. I'm kind of amazed. Oh, we're getting close, we're getting close. All right, let's let it filter down a little bit. Bump, 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 bump. Bump, 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 bump. Looks really cool, you guys. A little bit more rum. All right, now I'm trying to get all the air spaces out because we don't want air. We don't want this to rot. We want it to macerate. There we go. All right, I think we are almost there. Okay, I'm gonna clean off the top of this. I don't want any sugar, sticky ant. I don't want any ants. That looks amazing. Look at that, make sure spout is tight. All right, you guys, I think one more thing of rum, just to top it off here. 2 centimeters deep, we'll put it about there. All right, we've done it. Woohoo! Check that out. That is really cool. Let me see if I can give you a side view. Right, you guys, look at that. Who is making a Rumtopf today? We all are. All right, I think it looks pretty darn good, so let's get some plastic wrap on there. Okay guys, I'm gonna get some plastic wrap here. Everybody's favorite kitchen tool. I'm gonna make it double thick. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put one over, and I'm gonna stretch it out like so. And then I'm gonna fold it like so. So there we go, we've got a double wrap. Try to get the air out. There we go. Put that down. Nice. And then, I don't know about you, but I always have a kitchen twine. So let's get some twine out here and get entwined. It's a little joke. All right, so we got some twine. Here's what I'm going to do. Let's try a quadruple wrap. Ooh, look at that. Just about right. Let me shore up our strings here a little bit. Do, 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 do. All right. So, one that way. One that way. One more around. this way. Look at that. Let's try that again. Okay, guys, here's our string. We got one around there, one more around there, one more around each, and we'll tie it like an apron in the back, just with a little tightening and a bow, and a little bow. And I'll scooch it around the front, I think, maybe. Nope, just leave it like that. All right, there we go. Check it out. Cinched, ready to go. Let's go set this in a nice dark place. All right. All right, you guys, there is our Rumtopf. All right, you guys, there is our Rumtopf. It is good, it is secure, it has nice strings, it has a plastic top, it has 2 centimeters of rum, it has sugar. We're gonna set this aside and we're going to let this sit until probably maybe Thanksgiving. Since I'm not gonna be here Christmas, I think we're gonna do it at Thanksgiving. And yeah, so there we go. All right, let me show you some other views. All right, here is the glamour that is our Rumtopf. It's not very sexy yet, but in a couple months, that is going to turn into goodness. Oh, goodness. All right, let's try a couple glamours here without Bacardi. Look at that. Rumtopf. Rumtopf. Hipstagram. Rumtopf, looking good, sitting pretty on the counter. Thank you.